Hello and welcome to Roof Handles on YouTube again. What I've done is I've set up my display roof, which is sitting on a counter bench. And I'm just going to show again how a roof handle works. Now, this is my tech gun. Just wind that off a little bit, the tech screw. You'll see the keyhole design in the roof handle. That simply goes, now I'm doing this looking at the camera, over and down. Tighten it up a little bit, stops. Too loose, and it may, as you miss with your foot a little bit, come around a bit. So just tighten it up a little bit. Some people have said, you know, it could have a wider tread area. Look, the amount of plastic in here, I think, was 285 grams of plastic. To go over that required a machine of 70,000 tons or something or other. Put it this way, I had all sorts of great ideas for roof handles, and the plastics injection moulding crowd sort of put me back in my place and said, hey, hang on a minute, you know, we can't do this, this and this. There are machines around that can do this, this and this, except each handle would have been costing us a fortune. Obviously, we'd pass it on to you, the customer. So, in terms of getting it out, now, like this, when you place, I'll do a side-on shot of my roof, when you actually place it on an angle like that, your foot is actually coming in. Actually, hang on, I'll go and get a shoe. You're actually coming down, if I can do this, more on there than you are vertically. You're not trying to put your foot in there as a toe hold, if that makes sense. You're actually on that, more of an angle. And it actually works good because you're on the ball of your foot and it's somewhere to go. Put it this way, I've done it with bits of wood. I've taken out tech screws and I've put bits of wood across and I've slipped off of them and I've done a myriad of things trying to get up roofs and then came up with these. Simple, light, easy to use. And very, very tough. You can... Now, there's been some concerns. I had someone write to me and say, oh, look, you know, a tech screw will snap. And he was a builder, apparently. Well, I'd like to know what buildings he built because he's got no idea. That tech screw, you could swing half a ton off of that. Look, that... I can't put enough force on here to do anything. I could hit it with a hammer. I'll refer you to... I drive trucks as well. Next time you see a truck, have a look underneath the prime mover where the first trailer goes on. And if you ever get the opportunity to see a truck, or a trailer, sorry, without the prime mover under it, have a look at the pin that goes in to the prime mover. It's probably only 3.5 inches... by about an inch or so. Now, the road trains I drive, we get up to 98 tonnes gross vehicle mass. So there's probably 76 of that, 78 of that, hanging on to that pin behind there. It's called shear force. You're simply not going to shear that off. You cannot shear that off. Even if it's rusty, that'll hold no end. Now, there's a typical batten in behind a house. Okay, that size there. I've even got up on the shed there. In fact, I might do one up at the shed there, and I'll show you. Even without that tech screw in there, I can climb my shed. So I'll put my money where my mouth is, and I'll climb the shed without any backing. You won't shear that off. Not in a blue fit. You could hang an enormous amount of weight off of that. As I say, I can't put enough on there. Oh, well, enough of this. I'll load it up.